Hello, fellow slaves. Prohibitions don't work. It only took about 5 months for the fat cats with their big brains sitting in the Tule house to hear that penny drop and echo down the hall, empty hallways of this super extended state of disaster lockdown. It's something that the Americans already realized in the 1920s when they prohibited alcohol from being sold. And they enriched the likes of Al Capone, bootleggers and moonshiners, as well as drive a steeply increasing crime rate. And at some point, the Americans went, okay, this is a terrible fucking idea. Let's just make the sale and consumption of alcohol legal again, because it clearly hasn't worked. Do the war on drugs next, but more on that later. So we've lost about 100 million rand a day. 100 million rand every single day in sin taxes on alcohol and tobacco products that just didn't find its way into SARS's coffers because people weren't legally buying alcohol and tobacco products. People didn't stop buying alcohol and tobacco, by the way. In the one estimate that was, I think, in Business Day or Biz News, 90% of all smokers admitted openly that they had no problem acquiring their stash all throughout lockdown. I can promise you it is far in excess of 90%, because I know a hell of a lot of smokers and not a single one of them wanted for tobacco or cigarettes or anything like that. They all managed to find their stash. And I can promise you the same amount of drinkers, alcohol ban didn't stop them. They found their booze. The only real effect is the prices inflated astronomically. This is what happens with black markets. You prohibit something, goes into the black market, the price increases by 100, 200, 300%. Quality usually goes down as well. So all you've done now, you big brain Latuli house geniuses, is you've made people drink more expensive alcohol that is probably unsafer or more dangerous for their health, and smoke inferior tobacco products. Not that you're complaining, because you're probably getting a lot of that money channeled into Latuli house by your connections in the criminal underworld. Again, prohibitions don't work. They drive unsafe inferior products, they drive violent crime, they facilitate the financing of criminal activity and international terrorism. So unless those are your goals, prohibitions don't work. Funny enough, Becky Taylor came out, it was today or yesterday, I think, where he said, you know, we've arrested 300,000, convicted 300,000 people of lockdown offences over the lockdown period, as if criminalizing 300,000 South Africans is something to crow about, something to be proud about. Guys, this is a tyrannical police state. This is not a normal, healthy democracy when we conduct ourselves in this manner. The fact that prohibitions don't work is not a surprise, okay? You prohibit alcohol, you prohibit tobacco, people will still find those products readily, happily, and they will pay for them. It's the same with hard drugs. If you want them, you can find them pretty much anywhere. If you want to solicit the services of a prostitute, it's illegal and prohibited. You can find plenty of so-called sex workers in the right/wrong parts of town. This is not something I believe we should even need to have a conversation about, because the proof of the pudding is very much in the eating. Prohibitions don't work. So why, oh why, do we keep on pushing for them? Because bear in mind, the alcohol and tobacco bans can be brought back at any time under this Disaster Management Act. You're not out of the wood yet, kids. In fact, your supreme overlords have told you that if you misbehave, they will be brought back. Like the children you are. You are clearly not to be trusted with adult vices, but you're expected to pay taxes and vote. Bear this in mind as well the next time people talk about gun control. What will happen if we prohibit guns is only outlaws will have guns. Them and the government will have the sole monopoly on the use of armed force, and seeing as how they've treated the citizenry all throughout the lockdown, do you really think it's a good idea that the government and the criminals are the only people with guns? So, going forward, I suggest gun owners have suffered under this type of second-class citizenship status for decades. We know the gig. We'll stand with you in fighting for your rights. If you stand with us, the next time these idiots are going to try and ban guns. Because I can want you to bet your bottom dollar, they will definitely try it at some point, because the ANC hates guns in civilian hands. On that note, I hope you have a fantastic Monday. Get your smokes and your booze tomorrow. Fuck the ANC. Fuck the government. Fuck the lockdown. And Cyril Ramaphosa and the NCC. Bye-bye.